Pedal-friendly full-face helmets. A growing market and one that we're very excited about. So today we rounded up 6 helmets. We're gonna be doing a shootout. We've spent a lot of time in each of these helmets. Thanks to CompetitiveCyclist.com and the brands, we're gonna be giving away 2 of them and kind of go over some of the features, prices, and what we like best about each one. And we're also gonna address a couple of critiques and some of the areas we think some of the helmets could be better. So let's dig in. The first helmet we're gonna be discussing is the Fox ProFrame. Weighing in at 754 grams, this helmet has 15 intake vents, 9 exhaust vents, has a MIPS option, dual density Varisorb EPS liner, a Fidlock snap buckle closure system, a fixed visor, which is one of our critiques, and retails for $259.95. We've got the IXS Trigger. It weighs in at 603 grams, is the lightest of our grouped helmets here. It has 11 intake vents, 13 exhaust vents, has a unibody in-molded EPS with X-frame bracing. It also has a Fidlock closure system and is the only helmet, I believe, in our roundup to have an adjustable closure system in the back. Retails for $259 and is definitely one of our favorites. Next up, we've got the Troy Lee Design Stage. Weighing in at 636 grams, this helmet has 11 intake vents, 14 exhaust vents, comes with MIPS, it is a polylite shell with fiber reinforcement and a dual density EPS liner. It uses the Fidlock snap closure system and retails for $299.
Smith Mainline is 804 grams in a size medium. It has 21 fixed vents on it. Nothing can open or close. It has Coroid, which is their proprietary protection system with a MIPS liner inside. It's DH certified. It has 3 sets of cheek pads, a few different neck rolls that come with it, and it does have a D-ring securing system, which was one of our dislikes on that helmet. MSRP's for $300. This is the Cali Invader. It weighs 738 grams. It has so many vents we didn't bother to count, as you can see. It has an adjustable visor on it. It has their proprietary low density system. It's similar to a MIPS. It decreases rotational force, and then a EPS in molded liner as well. It's not DH rated. It's only bicycle certified. So it's the only helmet out of the range that doesn't have a DH rating on it. It is a fairly light, kind of general use, very well ventilated helmet. This is definitely the most flow we had out of any of our helmets. And the last helmet we have is a 7IDP Project 23 Carbon. This one kind of blends the downhill and pedal bike segment. It's the heaviest of our helmets at 976 grams. It is a full carbon shell with their slip plane system in it with a dual density EPS liner. So it has 3 different liners in there, which does increase the weight. It has 23 different vents in it, no mesh in any of their vents, so it does breathe very well. It is the highest rated DH helmet we have out of the lot. It carries the highest impact rating, $349.
I think it's probably worth noting that this helmet is definitely different than these helmets.
I mean, just look at those.
Yeah, right? I mean, we put that helmet in this shootout, not necessarily because Seven markets this as their pedal-friendly enduro helmet, but over the summer, we've all been riding this helmet so much and have grown to love it that we've just wanted to keep riding it and pushing it into different categories. And the fact that it is, you know, relatively light and does breathe fairly well has us riding it quite often on our e-bikes.
I ride it up every week.
Yeah, like shuttle days, enduro rides. So it's definitely more downhill focused than a lot of these helmets. So if you are a guy who's looking for maybe like a transfer stage helmet, the most protective, heavy mountain bike helmet that you can take into a downhill park, definitely gonna feel the most secure and safe in that helmet. Again, a lot of these pass the DH, you know, chin bar certification. There are rumors all over the internet of some helmets snapping and having issues. Obviously, we haven't seen or had those issues ourselves, but that's going to be the DH heavy winner for sure. Moving on to some of the other helmets, this is the exact opposite, right? Yeah. That is, it is not a DH certified chin bar or helmet, and it is the most ventilated. It's very light, and I would say, like, I can visualize this helmet on kind of like that, you know, that older demographic of rider, someone who's maybe not super crazy, but also doesn't want to lose their pearly whites, you know, like going down as they're trying to get better on the bike. So
this one screams sunglasses and helmet together, sunglasses and full face.
Yeah. So that's, I would say this is the trail biker's full face
but
helmet.
Still carries, I mean, Cali does some of the
absolutely
the best protection in the market.
Totally.
And I think that it carries a really good amount of protection for the weight.
Absolutely. Yeah, not to take anything away from the safety of that helmet. I mean, I wear a Cali Moto helmet on a dirt bike and absolutely trust them. That's just, I'd say this is gonna be more your XC side of the spectrum.
For sure.
Whereas that's the DH side. Fox, good ventilation.
Yeah.
Very open chin bar, mouthpiece, love the big open vents over the brow. Fixed visor is a bummer. Definitely a bummer there. It's pretty light, it breathes well, like the Fidlock. It feels secure, love that they've got MIPS. Mm-hmm. Anything else I'm missing there?
Interior channeling is the best out of the lot.
Yeah, yeah. It's a comfy helmet. I feel safe in it. I know, you know, some people have said there's been issues out there. Again, we haven't seen it, but
I didn't love wearing goggles with it just because the strap, if you turn your goggles around, the strap does like to fall down into your eyes.
Fixed visor. One of the reasons we don't like
yep.
that. All right, IXS Trigger.
Pretty good.
Like? Yeah.
Like it's light, it's comfortable, it offers great protection and good airflow. It has an adjustable visor.
And
yeah, it's, you can decrease the amount of tension on any climb, give it a little bit more comfort.
Yeah, I would say that this helmet is definitely probably near the top of the list for me, especially if you go on longer distance rides or you're gonna be wearing the helmet for a long period of time. Having the ability to kind of fine tune that fitment, you know, if you've got a long climb, you can easily loosen that up, let the helmet kind of get looser on your head, get more airflow going in, and then cinch it back down before you drop in. Like the little padded, you know, chin bar, Fidlock, really cool helmet. Downsides, I guess, would be the goggles.
The goggle situation.
The visor is adjustable. You definitely got to put some pressure into it, but because of how I think boxed off, like the end of that visor is, you kind of have to take some extra time to get the visor or the visor strap where it needs to be. We've had the visors come down and hit us in the face before, so. That would be kind of our one critique really about that helmet.
Other than that, it's a solid helmet. Really like that one.
Stage?
From the time I did spend, it has low amount of airflow. Similar, I would say, to a downhill helmet in its venting. It just has some more side venting in it. The fit and finish isn't amazing. It has a lot of...
Externally, it's really nice.
The paint jobs are awesome. Like with any TLD product, their paint jobs are awesome. The interior fit and finish isn't awesome. A lot of exposed EPS on the inside where a lot of the other ones have, you know, a cap over the top.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's got a Fidlock system, it's got MIPS, it's got a very comfortable system that you can dial into your fit. Pretty good all around helmet, visor's adjustable up out of the way. You could fit a set of goggles in there.
Their padding's nice, as always.
I mean, they use the X-Static.
I mean, they always have nice padding. So it's a good helmet. For sure.
Yeah, I think it's a great helmet.
It's a good helmet.
For the price, I wish it had a few little touches, right?
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah.
Smith?
The Smith helmet is the heaviest without the 7IDP in the lot.
Right.
800 grams, but I think it brings the most to the group. It has a lot of thought out touches, including MIPS, the choroid, and an EPS liner. The chin bar's fully certified and tied into the main helmet, so it's not like a full two-piece design.
Has a really nice shape, looks good.
The helmet looks really good, especially with, they've built it around their squad goggle, and it fits like perfect. The airflow actually channels air into your goggles. So the whole package on this, if you're using the Smith product, this would be my kind of choice here, because it just offers everything. You're giving up a little bit in weight, but once you get this dialed in, it's really comfortable.
Okay, the downside.
Downside is the D-ring.
Yeah.
It's a huge downside.
It is a big downside. So the D-ring system, obviously we've all used it for decades. For some reason though, these are like so close together and exactly the same size. So it's really hard to split those two loops apart to undo that helmet. Beyond that, I agree. This is one of my favorites out of the bunch, and I have a real hard time picking one winner. I just don't know. Yeah. If I'm going to the bike park,
oh,
and
it's the 790
P. I'm picking that for
no
sure.
Question. Even if I'm on a big enduro day where I'm just popping my helmet out for a transfer, the 790 P.
Okay. So then the next step is the pedal friendly category.
Man, I just think I really like the fit and finish and the look of the Smith, and I'm gonna stay with the Smith.
Okay. Gosh, I'm so torn. I love the fact that the IXS is adjustable in the back, that it's light, mm-hmm. it's very breathable. I think I like kind of the colors, the look, the finish of that Smith a little bit better. I think I'm gonna find myself wearing this probably a little bit more on bikes 150, 160 mil and up. And I would probably opt for this helmet if I'm riding 140 to 150-ish.
Yeah, like
maybe
an
160
trail
on a mellower
ride.
Trail ride, right? Like if we're gonna go shuttle Oak Ridge, this is a great bike. It's a long day. I still want full face.
Well,
safety,
and you're losing 200 grams, right? And that's gonna wear your neck out faster.
And I love the Fox, but just some of those features, the lack of the adjustable visor, et cetera. It's still a really solid helmet. I like this. I still wear it quite often, but Smith and IXS are probably the cream of the crop for me.
I think, we have a buddy that rides the TLD, and that convinced him to ride full face all the time.
Yeah.
So for the right person, that might be the right one as well.
Absolutely. Yeah, and I think, bottom line, even though these helmets are kind of targeted in the same market, they will definitely be better for certain riders and certain applications, right? I mean, this helmet may not be the best for us, but there are, I'm confident, a lot of people that this is the best helmet for them. Mm-hmm. And the weight and ventilation is gonna make it a solid winner. So before you click out of here, we are gonna give away this Stage and this Cali Invader helmet. They're the only couple that we could get extras of. The rest of them are a little too dirty and stinky, so you probably won't want them. However, competitivecyclist.com has given us a discount code. Use LoamWolf15, and any applicable product in their store will be 15% off. So how do you win either of these two helmets? Subscribe and leave a comment down below. As long as you subscribe to this channel and have left a comment on this video, we are gonna pick two winners to get these helmets. This is a size small.
Yep,
this is an extra small / small, and this is the large through double X. So we got two ends of the spectrum. If you got a big head or a small head, make sure you enter. And even if you don't, subscribe anyways, because then you can watch us talk about bike stuff more. Who doesn't wanna do that? So thanks again, guys, for tuning in. Have a good one, and we'll see you out on the trails.